Who are we going to next?
Governor Reeves.
I understand, Gov, you're not on video, but you are on the telephone. So, Gov, fire away.
Well, thank you, Mr. President. When we spoke on Friday, you assured me that when we asked for the pre-landfall declaration that you would immediately sign it, and you did exactly that, and I want to thank you for doing so. We're in a little bit of a different position right now, obviously, than our friends in Louisiana. The storm is, the eye of the storm is currently west of Jackson, and so we probably have between 18 and 22 more hours of the eye of the storm being in the state of Mississippi. We also have, because it's such a large storm, our largest threat in terms of tornadic activity still remains along our coastline and in the counties just north of there. The storm, which really is challenging, has slowed down to about 8 miles an hour, and so that's the reason it's going to stay in the state for so long, which leads to more and more rainfall. So the bad news for us is that we're going to get even more rainfall than maybe we originally anticipated. The good news is, because it's moving so slow, the wind speeds have not reached where we thought they would be, in the 65 to 75 mile an hour range here in central Mississippi. They're really closer to 30 to 40 miles an hour. Certainly still providing some significant challenges, but not to the extent that it otherwise could have been. Because of that, we know that our greatest threats here in Mississippi are with respect to rising water and power outages. The storm has been in the state for about 8 to 10 hours now. We've got 135,000 plus Mississippi dwellings that have not and cannot receive power right now. We're working on that, but we anticipate that number to significantly increase over the next 20 hours as the storm continues to move north. We have determined in meeting with our team, Mr. President, as well as your team at FEMA earlier today, that the SARS assets, the search and rescue teams from FEMA in our state, are not currently needed in our state. We believe our state and local assets can meet the needs, and so we have encouraged our FEMA counterparts to release those individuals over to Louisiana to help with those search and rescue.
Good.
As well as I have directed General Boyles, my adjutant general, as we progress over the next 8 to 10 hours, he has already reached out to his counterpart in Louisiana, and we're going to be sending men and women in uniform from Mississippi to help in Louisiana, because that's who we are. And so we've got, about 20 hours ahead of us of winds and lots of rain. But all things considered, because the storm slowed up so considerably, we're seeing more rain, more water, but a lot less wind, which is certainly helpful.
Well, thanks an awful lot, Gov. And again, thanks for your generosity in sending some of those search and rescue teams to Louisiana. And is Mayor Cantrell on? Mayor Cantrell, are you on? I don't think she was able to get connected.
I don't think so, Mr. President, but we have Cynthia Lee Shang.
Oh, okay.
Parish president from Jefferson Parish, which includes Grand Island and other
places hard hit.
Well, you were hard hit, weren't you, Madam President? Especially
thank you.
Down
yes,
Grand
we were. Island. Thank you, Mr. President, Congressman, Governor. Thank you. We have not had contact with Grand Isle. Congressman, you know Mayor Carmodel. I talked to him yesterday evening. He thought 40 people were on the island, couldn't get them off, including some firefighters. We have not had contact with them since yesterday. I'm told that the Mayor Carmodel's in Galliano, and Governor, I think he's on a helicopter by the state police, is what I heard, to get him to the island. And it's just, as long as there's communication, we'll be able to communicate with him and see what's going on there. But it's very hard to not have any word from that island and the people on it since that time. In Lafitte, the water was very high to the roofs of houses. Our first responders, Sheriff Joseph Lapinto, our firefighters, Louisiana National Guard, some Coast Guard are there doing search and rescue They're having to get boats in and out. We are sheltering those people at Park Playground. And then I believe the state is going to coordinate, Governor, for a pickup and move them out to Alexandria, is my understanding. And then, of course, our systems are down. We have no electricity, no communication. Our water systems are down. We're losing pressure. We had to do a boil water advisory. Our sewer system, as you know, is based on electricity. So we're going to start having backups there. So that's going to be a hygiene problem. And we're encouraging residents who are out of the area to stay out because we do not have the modern amenities to bring them back home. And the people inside, you know, we're going to have to take care of them. But some of the people in here who stay during the storm and are okay, in the next couple of days, they may want to get out. And it might be a best idea for them to get out because it's going to be difficult life for quite some time.
Thank you, Madam President.
Thank you.
Cedric, what about the oil port?
Well, the governor or Parish President Shane could talk about that. The president's inquiring about the oil ports down in Port Fouchon and the effect and where we are there.
I personally do not have eyes on that situation. So actually, the visual I get is if I see something on the national news, but I don't have word about that.
Thank you.
Governor?